wouldn't get involved in this stuff physically. But don't make the mistake of thinking that for a second, I'm not the same damn guy I've always been. I'm telling you right now, you cross a line with me, I'm gonna leave you lying.
All right, I wouldn't want you to take this nice suit off, fold it up, and put it in your wife's purse, where obviously you keep your cell phone as well as your balls.
Oh!
Cena! Cena hooks both legs!
Gentlemen, and welcome to this episode of The Wrestling Wrealm. This is the remarkable, the impeccable, the real Dwayne Allen. I am Mr. Main Event BDuB, and on today's show, we are going to look back at this week of some wonderful wrestling, man, I tell you.
That is right, ladies and gentlemen, the business is back. And of course, we're in the Wrestling Wrealm to discuss it, as we always do. You got a problem with it, you know what you can do. Anyway.
Woo, I tell you, you know, first of all, before we get into what actually happened in, on screen, I gotta address an idiot.
Okay, don't be so harsh.
Yeah, I hate to say this, because I really like this guy, man. And okay. He's one of my favorites, or used right. to be, Matt Hardy.
Ah.
You know.
Yeah, yeah.
You talk about talent being thrown away.
Yeah.
And I thought that once his brother Jeff did all his shenanigans, that maybe, just maybe, Matt would come around and say, you know what, let me be the bigger brother that I am and right. do what is correct. No! A DUI? Come on now.
Yeah, tough situation for Matt Hardy to be in. Naturally, I guess his personal issues, his demons, his frustrations, I guess where his career's going, everything as far as the business and, you know, where he's at. Naturally, I guess it's gotten the best of him. Mm-hmm. And Matt Hardy being known as being the most stable brother,
yeah.
the one that seemed to have it together and to be there to sort of downplay the true issues of his brother Jeff and a lot of situations they end up in. But, sad to see him go out the way he has. It's been frustrating to watch his career. Not necessarily his fault all the way around. Right. But, you know, naturally, he's dealt with a lot of adversity. Hopefully, he can take this opportunity to really, really get back to the way he was, where he was probably the most healthiest, the best in shape, and, you know, the most productive in the ring. So,
yeah, certainly.
Best wishes to Matt Hardy. In other news, heard that Jeff got called back to TNA. Supposed to be going back to work on Thursday, I guess, whatever that means.
Why?
Desperate.
You know,
TNA's desperate.
Yeah, but, you know, that stuff
desperate.
Like that, man. You know what I mean? You mean
desperate.
Tell me I can go out. What other job can you go out there, get high of highest of high, come up, show up high, ruin. Do your job improperly, and come back and work?
There's a reason Vince doesn't put up with that kind of stuff. There's mm-hmm. a reason the WWE is the top dog, whether people get upset about it, the WWE realm or not.
Hey, hey,
this is the main event show.
Exactly. The main event show. So let's move on to the main event.
The main event.
How about, you know who I want to talk about first?
Yes.
My boy Tyson Kidd. Everyone knows I'm a Hart family fan to
right.
the fullest. This guy is the last graduate of the dungeon.
Okay.
And to see him going out there and executing week in and week out, this guy's getting to the point where he can have a good match with a pillow.
I think it's good for Tyson Kidd because... And like I said, I respect guys who paid their dues. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when they split up the Hart Dynasty, it wasn't much for them to do anymore as a tag team because of the depleting tag team division and depleting veterans that can make the tag team division, which I guess they're trying to get back up to par, you know, to the past. But having him be on Superstars week in and week out
mm-hmm.
and work with Superstars and then finally see him on SmackDown making moves after Harassment was released and you see Natalya doing her thing, it's actually good to see him actually taking advantage of the opportunity given to him. A lot of people complain about not getting the chance to do certain things, but he's been given his chance, and he's been doing a tremendous job in the ring.
Certainly.
And you notice things like the way the commentators talking about him and the way they're building him. And it's like, you know what, he has a bright future. So
mm-hmm.
it's good to see him not be underutilized just because he's a smaller guy, but having
right.
go out there and have matches with a lot of the people like Justin Gabriels and the Daniel Bryans, you know, things of that nature, so he can really show what he's able to do. He's, you know, he's great in the ring, you know.
Yeah,
so.
You know, and I could see a match down the line, maybe by Survivor Series, Royal Rumble,
mm-hmm.
a good match between him and Cody Rhodes for the IC title.
I would love to see him as an IC champ. I would love to see him get a proper build and beat Cody Rhodes for the IC title.
Yeah.
I think he would really do that title justice. Not the fact that because of whatever, but I think he would represent what that title has always meant, and that was the workhorse title.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a workhorse. You know, he's proven that. You don't hear him complaining about different things. You don't know what's going on backstage, but as far as what he's able to do, you know, he shows up, he does his job well, and he goes home. And, he has a little bit of character to him, you know. He's appealing. He's not just a boring guy because I'm Darren Russell's, you know. He can... You saw a stint of it when he had the whole bodyguard gimmick. And then even those superstars, he was going back and forth with managers. So that's something you can definitely do with him.
And I'm hearing my boy Cameron G said, you know, he was telling me, making me aware of the fact that Bret Hart has recently signed a deal with the WWE as a Legends deal and then possibly a contract. And that he would be going to SmackDown. You know, what better way to have...
Is it actual full deal?
Well, this is what I'm hearing.
Okay.
Know? And shout out to Cam for, you know, relaying that information to me.
Right.
But if this is a deal, then we could have Tyson Kidd and Bret Hart together. And Bret Hart could be a perfect manager for him.
I mean, it would work. I mean, I heard that he was going to be the general manager for SmackDown because they're going to be in a... I'm not sure if they're going to be in Calgary, but I know they're going to be in... Is it Calgary? I know they're going to be in Canada for SmackDown. So that's what I heard. But I heard he's supposed to be like the guest general manager for that night or whatever the case may be. But I mean, it's good. It's always good to see Bret Hart come back and contribute to the business now. Not only, you know, now, granted, he can't do anything in the ring, but at least he can, character-based, can still do it. So, I mean, that's always a plus to be Hitman back and then having... You know, one of his proteges, somebody he's grew up, you know, knowing and watching him grow as a wrestler, have him on the same show, I think would be very beneficial for Tyson Kidd. So.
Certainly. You said tag team. Let's take a look at our brand new tag team champions.
Your days as the perky, cute, blonde little princesses are officially over.